Cook as friend. What an amazing days. This is the season of many things, of love, of going out with friends, holidays, but it's also the season of a lot of nice vegetables. Let's go to check together what the market offers for us to prepare incredible recipe. Come with me. Come. We are in Ales Turgus, the only one market in the center of Vilnius. Maybe the most popular one. It's open every day except Monday. Come with me, let's go to check what we can find. Sono reso, faccio una calbo la becare le due. Due bulve, io calime due. Morco, struputi, viene a porri. Ah, scita, la becare. Here, Vienna Svogune. Oh, I will take one. Now is this. What we have here? San Petrajoves.
Crapu Merica.
Gnaccio. Mania la beva dinga crapu. Viscas. Asparagus. Giale. This. Kaip yra šydo? Opa, opa. Na, šydos gerai.
O šitą nenori?
Šitos, I will get.
Viena?
Yeah, viena. As I said, we made super shop. We can go to prepare something super nice, guys. I'm so happy. Now we are in the closest part of this market. Here you can find a lot of nice meat and cheese from the countryside of Lithuania. Come to visit also this part of this market. Ales Turgus, remember. Lava Diena. Aš labai norėčiau sviestas.
Sviesto?
Yeah. Kokią turite? Aš žinau, kad čia labai skanu sviestas.
Sviestas yra sūrio čiaso.
Čiaso? I'm looking for fresh butter, so it's perfect here.
Okay.
We are ready to go to cook something amazing together. I found everything we need. Let's go, guys, to my home kitchen to prepare amazing risotto. So, cookers friend, finally we are in my kitchen with market shop. We found incredible vegetable and we can go to prepare amazing risotto with pore and asparagus. After this video, you will be able to do it at home and the result will be successful. First thing we need to do, just cut the butter in few cubes like this and need to go straight in the freezer because this we will need later to whisk our risotto. It's time now to prepare our stock. After the butter in the freezer, this is the step we must do. Incredible stock will make super risotto, the result will be incredible. So in with the celery. Cut in big piece like I'm doing now. I wash it, but not too much. Like wash, but don't need to peel in too much because the vegetable have to give us the best flavor possible. The fire is still off. Some tomato, like this. Half of onions. One piece of potato also with the skin. I clean good the ground, but the skin of potato will give us some nice flavor. Also, parsley inside like this. Now, what we do, the part of the porri that we don't use, we go to cut like this. The end, no? So the end we can trash. Also the first part. But all the part that we will not use for the risotto, we can add in our stock to give stock of broth, how you want, to give this stock amazing flavor. Also with asparagus we do the same. The asparagus is very important to know how to treat it because it has three parts. The last part is too hard to eat, so it's perfect for the broth.
The second part in the middle is the part that have to be cooked for longer, we can say like this. And the end, the point of the asparagus is the part that need to cook just in the end. The soft, the nice taste of asparagus come all, most all from this part of the asparagus. So, let's split the asparagus in three parts. The hardest one that will go for our stock inside here. And we keep the point of the asparagus for later. This part we will cut in slim portion like this. I will show you. Get few of them like this. Slim, and we're gonna cook in the pan together with risotto. The last part, so we will continue later. The last part we split just in the half, in this way, and then again. And we will cook just in the last 5 minutes, guys. So it will be a bit crunchy and super flavored. Ecco qua, like this. This we will keep for the end, and this we will cook with the risotto. But now we are going to do the stock. Oh, I lost this. The base for our stock is okay, so we can turn on the fire with nothing, guys. No water for now. We have to burn a little bit the vegetable. Will give us the flavor we want, that amazing flavor that will help our risotto to get super, super nice. So now we'll fry a little bit the vegetable for 1 minute, and then in with cold water, about 1.5 liters, waiting that start to boil. But the water in the start have to be cold, because the shock, the thermic shock will have the vegetable, will give us even stronger flavor. The water start to boil, so it's time to add 4 grains of pepper, like this, and 1 big spoon of sea salt in the broth, like this. Now, what we do, don't worry guys, you will find the right amount of the ingredient in the end of the video, or of course in the description. If you go in the description, don't forget to leave for us a big, big, big like and to subscribe. So, as I said, in with grain of pepper, with the salt, lower the heat, 3 on 10, and cover it. Now we can move in the pan while the broth is going. I took my leek. What we do with the leek? We just remove the external part. One layer, like this, maybe two. And we go in the middle to get the best part. Hopla. That if you have big pot, you can still add in the pot with the broth. So we will use just half of pore of leek. I want to say Lithuania all the time. So we go to cut it slim in this way. You won't need to go so fast to cut it slim, so you can go also slower. The important is the result. So do it slowly, no, don't worry. And this, what we have in this hook border, is what we will need for our risotto. Of course, the rice then. So, turn on the heat for the pan. It's empty, as you see. In with a few big spoon of extra virgin olive oil. All the leek in the hot oil, don't worry guys, few minutes, and also the asparagus will go to meet this leek in the pan. Very nice. Use always wood spoon or plastic one, but I love wood spoon. Let's move this pore. The smell is incredible, incredible, super good. Our broth is going very well here. Also here the smell is fantastic. If you don't use all the broth, you can use easy the stock for something else later. Also to drink like this with some nice tortellini. So the leek is going. We can add also the asparagus. Try to do less mess possible. This way. Some nice salt in to get out all the water from this asparagus. It will help to cook it. Move the asparagus. Heat, medium high power, 6 on 10, like this. And cover it for 5 minutes. And we will be back in the pan to continue our recipe. 5 minutes pass. Our asparagus got a little bit soft. You can touch with a spoon anyway. If you don't feel that it's still that soft as you want, you can cook a bit more, but still they will cook with the broth, with the rice. Now, the next step is to toast our rice. The rice I'm using is long grain, Scotty one. I found in a shop, so you can find anywhere. It's very good for risotto. The secret I can give you is that for any person, you have to use 2 full hands. So we are in 3 today to eat, so we are going to add 6 full hands of this risotto here with asparagus. No fear, guys. So 2 portions and 3. But I'm very hungry, so I go a bit more. Now, what we are going to do, in up with the heat, no fear, guys, no fear at all. And we're gonna toast this rice for few minutes. You will see the rice will change color a bit. It's very important, this operation. While we do this, our broth already about half an hour going. So we can use it, open like this. Very important to filter the stock. You can see that the rice is already toasted. This is very important operation to let the rice don't get too soft then. Mix with our asparagus, so got some flavor, that is nice. Keep the heat high, I put 7 on 10 like this. And we start to use our stock, our broth, to give flavor and let the rice cook. Very important to cover the level of the rice all the time. So the rice have to be under the level of the stock all the time. And the stock of the broth, how you want to call it, have to boil all the time. It's very important, as you can see now, keeping boiling, very important. And often you have to move, turn your risotto. This will take out all the crack mole, all the best part of the rice, and will give the creaminess to the risotto. Very important to move often, to keep this, move often the rice. Keep the broth boiling all the time, and rice under the level of the broth. These 3 secrets to have incredible result. Soon. Broth in all the time, and now is the best moment. I love this cheese, my favorite one, Parmigiano Reggiano. Remember to buy the great one, the real one. Parmigiano is just Parmigiano. Nothing can beat this Italian cheese. We will use to whisk the risotto in the end together with the butter that is in the freezer. As I said you before, don't be afraid, you will find the ingredient in the end of this video or in the description. And remember to leave us a huge like and to subscribe to see all the recipes we made before, and all the recipes will come soon. As you see, going with the broth all the time, moving the risotto is a love story. You have to be close to him if you want great results. But then when you go to enjoy this with your family, with your friend, it's something amazing. The result is perfect, so just follow my step, you will see the result, guys. You will be the best risotto maker in town. You can already see the risotto coming out, the result is unbelievable. Left about 5 minutes. Yes, our risotto cooked 20 minutes, no more. So, in with last 2 spoons of broth like this, and with the last part of the asparagus. Usually this one don't need to cook so much because it's super flavored. This is the best part, as I said, and you can eat also no cook if you want. So let's put in, cook just for 5 minutes, don't trash nothing of it. It's the best asparagus. So now we move for the last 5 minutes, then for the next step, just stop the fire, stop the heat. Wow. And we go in with our freezing butter and Parmigiano. And that will be the magic. Here, in that moment, there in that moment will happen the magic. So, the point of asparagus meet the rest of the risotto. Amazing wedding now here. The smell is incredible. Opa. You can do what you want in a kitchen, but you have to move the rice. So, as I said, you see, don't forget to move the rice. It's coming. In this time, we can go to try if need some salt. Careful to don't burn the tongue. Need some salt, so in. Like this, not too much, because Parmigiano also will give the right flavor. E voilà, here we are! Risotto is ready. So, let's turn off the heat. So, the broth. As you see, no heat anymore. And out of the fire, we go to add our freeze butter in like this. Opa. In cubes here, and our Parmigiano like a snow. All in for lovers of poker. And here we go to whisk our risotto. This is the best part, guys. Sound on and sound of love for you. Risotto ready. It's a spectacle, guys. It's a spectacle. The smell is fantastic, so let's go to make a nice portion. And this is cook-cast risotto with asparagus. So good, so nice. The smell is for who tried this recipe. I remember you will find now in the end of this video all the ingredients. Fantastic, let's put some last on the top. Some touch of pepper, like this. And for all the risotto lover, this is a must. Look at this. As I said, you will find all the ingredients in the end of this video or in our description. Cook-cast risotto with asparagus. Cook-cast friend, as you see, also in Lithuania you can find a lot of nice ingredients to make your special dish at home. We went in the Turgus, in the market, like this, they call like this Lithuanian Turgus, and we found incredible asparagus. From that, we got idea to make this incredible risotto. I want to try it, still I didn't do it. I was trying just while I was cooking. Fantastic. In Ale's market we found a lot of nice ingredients and we met a lot of nice people. One lady advised us to try this kombucha, traditional Lithuanian drink made in Kaunas, if I remember good. Anyway, we will give you all the detail about this kombucha in our description. It's perfect match with cook-cast recipe risotto with asparagus. So guys, I advise you to try the risotto recipe with this incredible kombucha. See you soon on the tube, as always. Enjoy your food, guys. Mamma che buono, Charlie. Super good. Fantastico.